started, you can get yourself ready, your yoga mat, some water maybe. Hello everybody, welcome to Monday morning. I'm starting to lose track of days here, and it's Monday. I've had quite a introspective week, I guess, and I've been feeling a little bit tired and off, actually, so I'm just getting as much rest as I can this past week. So we'll see how that translates into yoga today. So if you're just joining, take a moment to get yourself settled, get your yoga mat. You could get some water or tea or whatever it is that you need beside you, and we'll start on our seat. And we'll just wait a couple minutes, since I think I'm a couple minutes early until other people arrive. And like I said, today, kind of be a bit more of a gentle flow is what I'm envisioning anyway. So we'll see how that translates onto the mat today. So just starting on your seat, we'll let everyone else join in as they arrive. Give yourself some deep breaths here. Maybe take a moment to shift around a little bit. Maybe roll your shoulders back. Just allowing yourself to feel comfortable and settled wherever it is that you're going to connect into your breath. Heart, hand on your belly, or both hands over your heart. And as you're breathing, see if you could move. If you find that your mind is already very active this morning, move into your heart space, or listening to your breath, or following or counting your breath to try to bring yourself into your body and into the present moment. Start today's practice with a call of Om. You're more than welcome to join, or you can also enjoy and listen. We'll start with a clearing breath. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. Inhale for Om. As you're ready, opening your eyes, and we're going to start here on our seat. So start by making just a little bit of movement here. You can move perhaps side to side a little bit. You could round your spine back and extend your heart forward, and just making a little bit of movement here, getting into the sides of your body, the front of your body. Yeah, there's some dogs out in the hallway. I don't know if you guys heard that, but dogs live on this floor and are a little bit feisty. And then if you'd like to add in some big circles, you could. So circling forward and then back, maybe a few times in one direction, a few times in the opposite direction. You heard that too, hey, Bocat? And just taking a moment to finish off wherever it is that you are, taking a moment to come back to the center when you're ready. And maybe walk your fingertips behind you a little bit and roll your shoulders back. Maybe lift your heart. You could also lift your gaze, or you could keep your chin down towards your chest. Take a couple deep breaths here. And coming forward, I'm going to take any forward fold that works for you. I'm going to bring my feet together, knees wide, but you can extend your legs forward or keep your legs crossed if you like. And just allowing your body to drape forward a little bit here. And when you're ready, coming back up. And if your knees are wide, bring them back to the center and just release that perhaps a little bit. Okay, so let's come around into tabletop here. Finding your way into child's pose for a moment. So you could make this child's pose a little bit more active, lifting your arms, lifting your armpits, your elbows. You could rest your hands and arms down, making it a bit more grounding, a bit more relaxing perhaps. And take a couple deep breaths here into the back of your body. So let your lower back expand. Let your exhale soften the front of your body towards the floor. You can stay here. You can take a little twist over to one side, taking both arms over to the side. A couple deep breaths into the side of your body. And then moving over to the other side. Just as you're ready, coming back through the center, and let's rise, let's come up to tabletop, hands underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips. Start with a little cat and cow, so on your inhale, lift your sit bones, lift your heart. On your exhale, round your spine, chin towards your chest. And you can keep moving like this at your own pace, and finding a little bit of space with your breath and the movement. Finding a rhythm that works for you here. And then we're going to make a little bit of side-to-side movement today, or you could add in some big circular movement, kind of like we did when we were seated. And maybe a couple circles in the opposite direction. And coming back to the center, if you like, you can draw up through your core, your navel towards your spine. You could extend your right leg back behind you. You could pause here, you could extend your left arm out in front of you. Take a couple breaths here, keeping your core engaged, drawing up through the center of your body. And just as you're ready, we're going to release and come back to the center. Take a deep breath here. side. So both hands can stay planted here, or you could extend your opposite arm forward. And when you're ready, come back to the center. We're going to take child's pose again. Option two, if you have blocks, you could bring your elbows, upper arms onto blocks. Walk your elbows forward and bring your palms together and bring your thumbs back towards the back of your body. Now you don't need to have blocks to do this as well. You can do this on the floor. Couple deep breaths into your heart space. So we're going to work on tabletop again here just for a moment. So this time a little bit of movement. So your inhale can be an extension of your leg. So you'll want to find a lift through your heart. Exhale, round your spine, chin to chest, push through your hands, and then inhale to extend back. Now if you're going to add your opposite arm, you want to really hug in and you still want to round. So you want to have that stability through your arm that's on the ground. And move with your breath here. And we'll just take a couple more. And when you're ready, we're going to pause in the center. Take a clearing breath. We could move through cat and cow a couple times if you like. And then we're going to come to the other side. So again, you could start with just your leg and draw in, press your arms to round your upper back, and then inhale, extend. Or you could bring both your arm, opposite arm and knee in, inhale, extending. Moving with your breath. A couple more times here. Coming back to the center. And again, we'll just take a moment to pause, maybe coming off your wrists. You could interlace your hands, circle at your wrists a couple times, shaking it out. Okay, so we will be moving into downward facing dog. If you're not feeling down dog today, you can move into standing forward fold instead. Taking a moment here to connect into your breath. Maybe make some movement in downward dog, stretching out your legs, back of your body. And just when you're ready, we're going to make our way into a standing forward fold. You can let your head release a bit more if you like. You could let your arms hang. You could grab opposite elbows, but give yourself a few breaths here, settling into your forward fold. You can always come up to stand if it's not working for you. Now, hands on your shins or blocks if you have them. Lift up halfway, inhale. Lengthen your heart forward. Exhale, fold back in. I'm going to do that a few more times. Inhaling, lifting up halfway. Exhaling to fold back in. And again, inhale. And then exhale. And place your hands on your hips and take an in-breath to rise to stand. And your exhale, arms beside you. Take a breath or two here. Okay, so if you're not at the front of your mat, you can make your way towards the front of your mat, and we'll get
And take an inhale, reach your arms up overhead. And then exhale, we're going to forward fold.
And then find your inhale to lift up halfway. And then exhale, fold in. And then we're going to rise up to stand again. So hands to your hips and reach your arms up this time. And hands to heart center, exhale. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lift up halfway. Exhale to fold in and rise to stand again. Inhale, reach your arms up and hands to heart center. Okay. Inhale, let's reach your arms up and this time exhale, forward fold. We're going to move a little bit more from here. Take an inhale here, lift up halfway. Now let's take a big step back with our left foot. Bring your left knee down to the ground and let's rise. Bring our hands up to our hips or you can have your hands on your front leg. Settling into your lunge here, and you can pause with your hands on your hips if you like. You can also extend your arms up overhead. Now, if you'd like a little bit of a side opener, grab your left wrist with your right hand, so your right foot's forward. Grab your left wrist and draw over to the right side a little bit here, shoulders back. When you're ready, coming back to the center, bring your hands down. Let's step back to downward dog. And then inhale, let's come forward to plank pose today. Shoulders over your wrists, knees up or knees down. Shoulders back, bend your elbows and slowly lower. A little bit of cobra here. A little cobra, you can use some core strength. Lift your hands away from the ground if you like. Now we're going to push back. You can move to downward dog if you like, or you can move to child's pose for a couple breaths, your choice. And then from downward dog, let's step our left foot forward. Right knee comes down to the ground. And from here, rise, bring your hands up to your hips. I know, Bo. Hi. My cat's staring at me from the perch above. You can't see it in the screen, but it's a little bit creepy. Reaching your arms up overhead. If your arm's overhead, you could grab your right wrist with your left hand, lengthen up, and then tip over towards the left a little bit here. So same side as your front leg is on, is forward. Shoulders back, couple more breaths. When you're ready, coming back. This time we're going to step forward. Take a breath in and lift up halfway. And then exhale, fold in. And then let's rise to stand again. Reach your arms up and hands to heart center. Hi, Bo. Okay, so, excuse me, a little bit of allergies today, so we'll see how this goes. I'm finding it difficult to breathe through my nose. We're gonna do a little bit of movement. So if you wanna pause and take child's pose or stay in down dog, please always give yourself those options. Skip the little extra bit of movement and just really honor where you're at right now. Take a deep breath in, again, reach your arms up. And let's take a forward fold exhale. And then let's lift up halfway, inhale. This time we're going to step our right foot back. You can choose a low lunge again, or you can lift up to a high lunge here. So reaching your hands to your hips, extending your arms up overhead if you like, or even coming to goddess or cactus arms here. A couple deep breaths, settle into your front knee, lift your heart. Your exhale, let's bring our hands down, stepping back to downward facing dog. And again, you can choose to stay here, you can move through this vinyasa if you like, coming forward to plank, or you can come to child's pose, knees up or knees down. Let's lower down. Inhale for cobra. And let's move to downward dog or child's pose for a couple breaths. And let's step our right foot forward. Back knee lifted or on the ground, your choice, rising up to a high lunge or low lunge. Again, you can have your hands on your hips, arms overhead, cactus or goddess arms here. Couple more breaths. On your exhale, let's step forward into our halfway lift. Inhale, exhale, fold. And then rise to stand. Inhale. And hands to heart center. And just take a moment in mountain to pause. All right, hands at heart center. Take a breath in here. And let's move our hips back and down. So knees stay over your ankles, sitting down and tailbone draws down. Then lift through your heart here for a moment, shoulders back. Navel towards your spine, take a breath in. You could also reach your arms up or forward. And when you're ready, let's forward fold. Take an inhale, lift up halfway. And then exhale, fold in. And then let's step our left foot back. Plant your left heel down. This time we're going to rise up for warrior one. Hips forward. Back toes are angled a bit more forward. You could pause with your hands on your hips. You can come to goddess arms. Or you could clasp your hands behind you here. Crack, crack, crack. Finding a bind, a little bit more of a heart opener. Connecting into your breath here again. As you're ready, let's bring our hands back to our hips, straighten out our front leg. Let's hinge forward. So you can have your hands on your hips or hands at heart center. And you could pause here. You could bring your hands to blocks if you have them. You can adjust your stride, especially if your back heel's lifting. Folding in for pyramid pose. When you're ready, let's walk our hands forward. Lift your back leg up behind you. Press through your standing leg. Fold in. Lift through your back inner thigh here. Now we're going to bring our knee to our chest, round in on our exhale. Inhale, extend your leg back. And exhale, knee to chest, forehead to knee. Inhale, extend your leg back. And one more time, exhale. Inhale, extend your leg back. Bring both feet forward to the front of your mat. Take a forward fold. Give yourself a moment in your forward fold. Couple clearing breaths, couple deep breaths here, maybe sway a bit. Inhale, lift up halfway. Exhale to fold in. And let's rise to stand. Reach your arms up. And hands to your heart. Exhale. All right. Okay, so chair pose. Feet together or feet apart. So your choice here. I'm going to bring my feet together for this one. Hands at heart center, allowing your hips to sit back and down. Tailbone draws down. Heart lifts up. Core engaged here. Couple more breaths. On your exhale, let's forward fold. Hi, come here. Inhale, lift up halfway. Exhale, fold. We're going to step our right foot back, plant your back heel. We're rising up for warrior one. Hips facing forward, bending to your front knee. Arm variations, anything you like. Connecting to your breath here. Keeping your back heel planted, maybe bend into your front knee a bit and then lift through your heart. And as you're ready, let's release. Start to straighten out your front leg. We're going to hinge forward, coming to pyramid pose. So your hands can come down to blocks, to the floor. You could adjust your stride a bit if you need to here. Connect into your breath. Soften in. When you're ready, lifting up halfway, walk your hands forward. Lift your back leg up behind you, and you could fold in here for a moment. Now our exhale will be knee to chest, forehead to knee. Inhale, extend your leg, lift up that halfway. So extend your heart forward. Exhale, knee to chest, forehead to knee. Inhale, extend your leg back, heart forward. Exhale, fold in. Inhale, extend back. One more time. Exhale. Inhale, extending back, and then feet come forward. Taking a forward fold here again. Maybe a clearing breath or two. You could grab opposite elbows. You could let your arms hang. Take an inhale, lift up halfway, and then exhale, fold. Let's step back to downward facing dog, and I'm gonna suggest you could stay here, you could move to child's pose, or you could move through vinyasa, your choice. And then we're going to step our right foot forward and rise up for warrior two this time. So back heel comes down. You can line up your front heel, the middle of your back foot. Okay. Here we are. So we're going to create a little bit of movement here today. So we're going to take our back hand to our back leg, front palm faces up. We're going to move back, and then we're going to come forward, elbow to front leg, extend your arm forward. So you can find your own rhythm for your breath here. Maybe this is your inhale, and maybe this is your exhale. Or maybe you take an inhale here, exhale, inhale, exhale. So finding your own rhythm, we'll just go one or two more times here. And last time here. Now we're gonna come all the way back up, straighten out our front leg, hands to your hips. Turn both feet to the long edge of our mats. Elbows in, take a breath in. Exhale, let's take a wide-legged forward fold. So I'm just gonna pause here in the center. You're welcome to move a little bit, lift a heel. Move a bit side to side if you want. And just folding in if you like as well. Just take a couple more breaths here. Hi, you've come to join us. Say hi today, hey? That's it. That's one little cat moment. So So we're going to lift up halfway. We're going to walk our hands around the front of our mat. We're going to come into a lunge here. So taking a moment, we're going to take a little bit of a twist. Your back knee can be on the ground or lifted. We're going to turn towards our front leg and either hand on your hip or extending your arm up here, shoulders back. If you'd like to take a thigh stretch here, you could also do that. Reach back instead. Grab the top of your foot. Of course, your back knee needs to be on the ground for that one. Taking this into a thigh stretch. Now we're going to release that. We're going to come down into lizard pose. So walking your right foot a little wider if you have room. Scoot your back leg back a little further. You could stay up on your hands. Some of you have blocks where you could maybe bring your elbows or forearms onto. What are you doing there, Bo? You're just out of camera range. What are you doing? Settle into this pose for maybe about 8 more breaths. So if it's not feeling, should be a slightly uncomfortable, hey, but not painful. Just when you're ready, we're going to come out. So you can find any release that you'd like. You could take a vinyasa. You could move up into down dog. You can hang out in child's pose. Whatever it is that you need here to release from that. And then when you're ready, we're going to step our left foot forward and we're going to come up to warrior two. Other side. Okay, so bend into your front knee here. We're going to create that movement again. So we're going to bring ourselves into reverse warrior and then extended side angle. And moving with a breath that works for you. Just going to take a couple more breaths here. And one more cycle of breath. Ending off on side angle. And then coming back to the center, straightening out our front leg. Hands to your hips. And again, let's turn both feet towards the long edge of the mat. Wide-legged forward fold. If you'd like to take the bind, you can take clasp your hands behind you, take a breath in here, and then we'll fold in. If you don't want to take the bind or it's just jamming up your shoulders, bring your hands down and connect into your breath here. Just take a couple more breaths wherever it is you are here. So So now we're going to lift up halfway. We're going to walk our hands around to our front foot, which will be the opposite of the last time. Hopefully it's your left foot. We're coming into a lunge, back knee down. And so turning towards your front leg in a bit of a twist here. You could keep your hand on your hip or reach your arm up. And again, you could also take a thigh stretch here. So grabbing a hold of your back foot, turning open. As you're ready with the release, we're going to come into lizard pose. So bringing your left foot a bit wider, maybe walking your back foot back. Some of you have blocks that you could use here, or you could stay up on your hands. Some of you might even be able to come down to the floor. Spend maybe about 5 or 6 more breaths here, settling into your breath, trying to let go a bit, soften in. Everybody, when you're ready, let's come all the way back. Child's pose, movement, down dog, whatever it is that you feel like you need on this side. Maybe set out a little bit. And we are going to make our way back into a standing forward fold for a moment. And then this time, just taking your time maybe to ragdoll up to stand. Okay. So coming up to mountain pose for a moment. So we're gonna do a little transition here. So we're going to work from tree pose, and so here or here, I'll turn the face forward in a second, and then we're going to take a quick transition, short transition into warrior three, and then we'll come back to stand. Okay, so tree pose would be here, here, or upper leg. We'll pause in tree pose, and then we'll take a little transition into warrior three and come back. Okay, alrighty, so standing on your right foot first, left heel can rest on your ankle, or you could bring your foot just below your knee, inside of your leg, or you can bring your foot above your knee, inside your leg. You just want to avoid your knee joint here. Find some length, and maybe any arm variation that works for you here. Now we're going to bring our hands back towards the center, either at your heart or on your hips. Bring your left knee forward, lean forward, and kick back with your left leg. And then you can keep your hands on your hips. You could have your hands at heart center. You could extend your arms back or any other variation here. And then we're going to tip back up. Come back to mountain. Give yourself a clearing breath or two. The other side might feel different. Starting in tree pose, standing on your left foot, your right foot can come
just with your heel on your ankle, your toes are still resting on the ground here, foot below your knee, inside of your leg, or foot above your knee, inside of your leg, and any arm variation that you like here. Core is drawing in, lengthening upwards at the same time as you're rooting through your legs. Bringing your arms, either hands to your hips, hands at heart center. Bring your right knee forward. We're going to kick that back, spending a few breaths here in warrior three, maybe a breath or two. Always tip back to standing sooner. And just when you're ready, coming back to the center, maybe taking a clearing breath or two. We're going to move down into Malasana squat pose. So a couple options. Midway squat. My toes are turned out. I want my toes to be pointing the same direction as my knees. If you have a yoga block, you can come sit on your block. And you can come all the way into squat pose here. Hands at your heart if that works. You can close your eyes if you like. Connecting into your breath. And just in your own time, in whatever way makes sense, we're going to move down onto our seats. Shake out a little bit here. Awesome. So I am going to offer pigeon pose today. Getting into our hips. I know for everyone that doesn't work. So if pigeon pose doesn't work for you, figure four on your back. So show both. Start with my left knee towards the left side of my mat. It's a little wider than my left hip. My right knee is going to draw back. Now if I'm feeling any pressure in my knee, I'm going to want to come out and come onto my back. And you could also fold in here towards the floor. If I was feeling pressure of my knee, coming onto my back here, left foot on top of my right leg here, or maybe here. Okay. So we'll stay for just a little bit of time here. So this is an opportunity for you to connect into your breath. Still some clearing breaths if you need to let go. And at any point, if you need to come out sooner, just come on out. Maybe find a nice release for yourself or something in between before coming out, before we make our way to the other side. Just taking your time to come out of the side, and if you're not there already, give yourself a little bit of a release, whatever that looks like for you, maybe some movement, maybe some stillness. And just taking your time coming to the other side. Now if you have come to pigeon on the other side and you do feel a bit of pressure in your knee,
You just come onto your back again, figure four pose.
Okay.
And just as you, whenever you're ready, connecting back into your breath, allowing yourself to settle here. Just a few more breaths here. Just taking your time when you're ready to come out. Again, you can make some movement here. You can find child's pose. If you're on your back, you could hug your knees into your chest, rock a little bit maybe. We will be coming onto our back next. So if you're not there yet, making your way onto your back, count your knees into your chest here. You could rock a little bit maybe, or you could bring your feet down to the ground and release your knees a few times from side to side. And then coming back to the center, we're going to take a little bit of a back bend, a little bit of bridge. So a couple options for anybody that has a yoga block. You could take a supported bridge by placing the block underneath your hips. The block has a few heights. You could just rest your hips on the block. For those of you that want to hold it, you could hold the bridge here. Even interlace your hands underneath you, connecting to your breath here. To release from that. And again, find a release. It could be knees to chest. It could be rocking your knees. You could also give yourself maybe a full body stretch here. Oh, oh boy. It's almost nap time after all that yoga. Just kidding. Oh boy. It's Monday and I've definitely had a very restful week. So I'm going to come to Happy Baby now. So you can bring your knees wider. You could have your hands behind your knees. You could grab your ankles or the bottoms of your feet here. Try to draw your shoulder blades back down towards the floor, connecting into your breath. You're ready. skin release. And taking bound angle posture, so bottoms of your feet together, knees come wide, hands can rest on your belly or your hips. You could also take a heart opener, taking your arms wide or taking your arms overhead a little bit here, as long as your arms and shoulders rest on the floor. Taking a few deep breaths into your body, your belly, your chest. Letting your exhale settle you, the back of your body a little bit more towards the floor. And then as you're ready, let's bring our legs back. You can find another release here for yourself. We'll take a twist. So I'm going to take eagle legs and cross one leg over the other. So I'm going to move my legs to the right. I'm going to cross my left leg over my right first. This is a deeper twist than stacking your legs. So if that doesn't feel good for your body, stack, unravel your legs. Just have one leg stacked over top of the other. Into your breath here. Unravel your legs first if you have them raveled and come back to the center. And then if you're moving your knees to the left, then your right leg will come over top of your left leg first. Connecting into your breath here again. Just as you're ready, we're going to return to the center. And if your hips have shifted, bring them back towards the center. And we'll take one more movement in the center, maybe knees to chest, maybe happy baby pose again, or anything else that you'd like. If there's anything else that you'd like to do before Shavasana, maybe take a moment to find whatever it is that you need, and then we'll come into Shavasana. Have a sweater or blanket, you could get yourself all nice and warm. And you know, some people are really comfortable lying flat on their back and some people aren't, so if you're not, you could lie on your side or child's pose, or even take Shavasana in a seated pose, and just give yourself a moment maybe to wiggle around. You need to give yourself a couple clearing breaths here. Give yourself permission to just surrender and just be. Give yourself the gift of this time to just settle here. body, or give yourself a full body stretch. Bring your knees up into your chest and rock a little bit here from side to side. And in your own time, making your way onto your side. Maybe taking a couple breaths on your side before making your way up to your seat. Coming back to your breath for a moment. Take a couple deep breaths of gratitude, thanking yourself for this time and being here. And I'll seal the class with an om. You can join in if you like from home. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. And then inhale. Thanks again, everyone. Namaste. I hope you have a wonderful day. Thank you. Thank you so much. So going forward, I'll be here Monday and Wednesday mornings for sure, 9 o'clock. This week, I'll be here Tuesday evening, and then I think after this week, Thursday evenings will probably be better options. So just keep an eye out on Facebook. I've also posted everything up on my website on the calendar going forward for the next couple weeks anyway. So good to see you all. Hope to see you again soon. Have a great day. Bye.